Hi, I've been receiving a number of questions about how you can manage the files that have been uploaded to the server. So we're going to look at that real quick in Dreamweaver right now. What I have is I'm in Dreamweaver, and we happen to be at the end of a semester right now, but this could happen early on in the semester very easily. And what I have open over here is I have my Project 5 demo folder open over here. Now, these are the files that we used for the demonstration within class, but they are the equivalent of what you end up doing for Project 5. And in this case, this being a PHP job, you built an HTML page, and once you are happy with that, you've got CSS in place, you've got content and so forth, you convert it over to PHP. And I recommended, in fact, here's an index.html file right here. I recommended that you do that work, save it, and then when you're happy with it, you close the file so you don't confuse Dreamweaver, and you just come over here and you rename it. And so you can select the .html right there and rename it to PHP. However, I have found that some people, in this case, have ended up duplicating it. So you'll see right here, I have an index.php and an index.html. So I have two copies, okay? The files are very similar. We could look at them real quick. There's my index.html, and here's my index.php. It has the PHP work done to it. So you see that PHP code is in there now. The thing is if you built the HTML file and uploaded it, then you, even if you renamed it into a PHP file, made your changes and uploaded it, you now have a PHP version and an HTML version on the server. Okay, so we know that an index file is the default file. That's what it loads when it goes and looks in your folder. But if you give it two index files, index.php and index.html, you don't know which one it's going to load. So I saw that happen just earlier today. So even if I come over here and I know I want the PHP, I could click on the HTML, I could hit the delete key on my keyboard, and I could answer yes, delete it. That's great. I don't have it here any longer, but it's already been pushed to the server. Okay, so how do we look at the server? What I do is I stay here in the files panel. I come up here to the top. See, I'm working in local files right here. This is my local root folder. Come find this little icon right here, this little square. When I hover, it says expand to show local and remote. I'll click on that. It expands it here, and what I end up with is here on the right, and they could be swapped, but usually here on the right, you see these are my local files. So this is what I was already looking at, and on the left over here, it says remote server. So this is the actual server that I'm pushing files to that other people can access. Or in this case, you do your work and I can access it there. Now, if you don't see any files here, it's probably just because you're not connected. You see right here, this plug icon is connected. If I disconnect it, okay, well, it's showing because it already knew, but you can easily come up with there being nothing here. So to see what's there, you just click right there and connect to the server. Okay, so here's what I have on the server. So to get rid of something on the server, just come over here where it says remote server. I'm going to come down here where I'm working. I'm working in Project 5 demo, and you see right here I have an index.html and an index.php. I only want the PHP file. This file is confusing matters. So I'm going to select index.html, click on the delete key. So do I really want to delete it? Yes, I do. So I say yes, and there you go. It's deleted it off of my server. So now it's no longer there, and this index file is what's going to load by default. Okay, so that's how I go work with files that are on the server from Dreamweaver. To put this thing back, you can simply click in the red dot right there, puts it back over here. Okay, so just a quick video. Figured it was easier to show you this than to try and explain it. Talk to you guys soon. Bye.